Hi guys, welcome to Runner's Lab. I was here to measure my body fat and my bone density because FIBO is coming up and I want to be prepared there and to show you the difference between training in cardio and muscle training. Okay? So I have been dieting for a while with just my food and nothing else. And as you notice, my body fat is now 9.6, so it's actually not that bad because I just done this with food and no extra trainings. Also, my body has very strong bones. My bone density is actually 1.44, and the average bone density is between 106 and 114. 114, sorry. So, because of my foods that I eat and my vitamin K, my bone density is very strong, and it's also thankful because of my martial arts with a lot of pounding on the bones, I would say. So that's also very important to get injured and so stuff like that, that you aren't too fragile. But enough about the bones. Let's check the fat things. As you see here, we have several dates that I already did a scan and several percentage. And here we have 8.5, that's from my competition that I did, that I had a very low rate. And you can also see the dates in between that I play with my weight very easily. Okay. So, furthermore, the food that you take is also very important. My metabolism is right now around 1,780, but I eat mostly without carbs. I do a lot of cardio. I also lost actually a lot of muscle because I didn't train a lot, and in this case it was a lot. I lost more than here you see, last scale that I did, I had 71 kilos muscle, now I only have 66. But my body fat is from 9 kilos to 7 kilos. Okay, my weight in the whole part is also less. So it's important that you eat healthy, you eat nutritious, and you check how your body reacts. I've done a long time and I do a lot of things with my dieting. I try a lot of things, also with sports. I even did heat saunas, I did intravenous, I did Taibo, stuff like that. Cardios, martial arts, food programs, you name it, everything. The cool freeze things and stuff like that to freeze the fat. And I get the best results by just running and watching my diet. So what I do with fitness and extra, it's giving me more muscle and my metabolic state in rest period is higher. So that's also a very good thing. So it's a positive thing that I burn my fat in a rest period also when I'm recovering from my cardio. But it's also important to know your body. Okay, so when I go train, I can smell on my sweat what's going on with my body when it has certain sense. I know my proteins are too high, or I know I'm burning muscles and stuff like that. And that's very important that you know that, because when you're smelling something and you don't know why, and it's from your body, you have to check it out. So try to find out what's the reason. Try to check your nutrition, your food, your supplements, what's going on. Okay. Also, hydration is very important. I drink a lot of water. Mostly don't drink any soda or stuff like that. I barely use sugars, and for sure I don't drink alcohol. Okay, so I'm not saying you have to be the 100 priest and don't drink ever. It's just a decision that I made, but it works for me very well. Okay, so this is the period that we have now on 9.6, and I'm going to come back to you in 2 weeks and show you the results already then. But I'm going to do more fitness and more cardio in the same time, because I want to get a FIBO and I have it on point. Okay? So stay tuned to the next episode. And by the way, you can see these slides I will add them in a PDF on the back so you can look at them. Okay, thank you.